To the Bishan-Toa Payoh residents living here. Yes. Tonight, I want to talk about three matters. One is something that you're all very concerned about. National issues like cost of living, housing. So, it's about what we as MPs will do for you if you elect us. And three, and I want to tell you about the seriousness of this vote. Why is it important for you? In the last 8 days, you have heard the opposition talk about many things. Some talk about alternative voices. Some said that a government must be accountable. Let me tell you this, the government is accountable. But the government is not accountable to the opposition. It is accountable to the people. Now, even in this election, if they did not get enough seats, there would at least be 9 opposition members. Because the government created or changed the rule to allow at least 9 opposition members to sit in parliament, whether as elected MPs or as non-constituency MPs. So you can see that if they want a voice, they will have a voice in parliament and there will at least be 9 of them. Having been in government for 27 years, I can also tell you this. The government is not perfect. No, by no means. The government can make mistakes. And when something happens, the government will admit the responsibility and find out what goes wrong so that we will not repeat those mistakes again.
Yes.
Come back to the people and account to the people about what we do. If the government is not accountable, do you think that at every election the PAP will be re-elected? Yeah. Definitely the PAP will be thrown out long ago. But the people continue to have faith in us. What we have not heard from the opposition is the important matters about our future, about the important matters of what you deal with our current problems and our future problems. The current problems like cost of living, like housing. What plans do we have to reduce the cost of living? Have you heard any?
No!
No. The NDP team have no idea what to do for you. We are in an expectation of what our team will do for you for the next 5 years. We had an expectation on the 3rd of April, just in Payoh Central. The chairman happened to walk by when we left. And he looked around and said, not bad. If they were elected, they will adopt our plan. Well, I think it's quite a flattery that they think our plan is good and they want to adopt it. But let me tell you this. These are our plans which we took a long time to came up with. We plan that we improve every year. What do you know of the SPP team? Well, I know from newspapers that they were only formed just about 2 months ago. 2 months. And in 2 months, they think they know enough about you about your problems and about what they can do for you. Well, pray. I leave you to judge whether they can do this or not. Well, when they say, if that one of the FDP candidates said, when he was asked, what do you plan to do for us? Well, he said, we are only, and I quote him, we are only at the beginning stage of the election. When the election is over, and we are properly set up, when we are properly set up, which means we are not at this time, we will produce all the ideas. So what does it mean? It means we have no idea now, but vote for me, then let me cook or think of something. That is what they say they will do for you. I will leave you to judge. Now, for us, we have been around here for a long time. We know your problem, and definitely you know that we have delivered promises, which we have made. As I have just mentioned it. I know that in this election, Singaporeans are excited to vote. You, living in Bishan-Toa, Payoh, GLC, are also excited to vote. And I can tell you that I'm also very excited to take part in this election. My last contest was in 1984, and I did my first rally in the morning in front of the Block 127 market. I think you know where it is. You believe it's Payoh, or if you have shops in Payoh. 127 market. We had two lorries parked together, and we were standing there making speeches. Now people came to listen to us. I was a rookie at the time, and since then, although I've not contested, I've spoken in many GE rallies, every term since 1988. And now I'm speaking here before you, telling you what we will do for you as a government and as your candidate. I'll tell you that there is no right or wrong way to vote. No. You will decide what this means for you, what the vote means for you. But it can be based on the party, it can be based on their ideals, it can be based on the personality, it can be based on the team, or it can be based on the team's plan. Right way, wrong way, you think. You think about some of these ideas. But there is a wise or dangerous way to vote. You want to vote in a wise way or dangerous way, well, you've got to decide in 2 days' time. And what is the wise way? The wise way is the simplest way, to best way to vote for the team that can best take care of you, your state, and your future. That is the wise way. What is the dangerous way? Dangerous way is, you think you can vote for the opposition, then other people can vote for the PAP. Well, if you do that, and when enough of people think like you, vote for the opposition for himself, and let other people vote for the PAP, then on the 8th, maybe on the same night, on the 7th, after the count, you can wake up to a very different place. You can wake up to the fact that there will be a new team in charge. Now that, I can tell you, is a dangerous way to vote. But I know that, and I have faith in you, that you can vote wisely.
Yeah, we are one for you.
Thank you.
We are wise.